Hello students. So in the last class, we discussed about the finding the capacity of pile using static method. So in today's lecture, let us discuss how the capacity of pile is derived using the dynamic method. So this method is usually used for driven piles. So before going into that, let us familiarize the various methods of pile drive. So the piles can be driven either by hammer or by providing some vibrations, and in some special cases we do mix drying, that is for some extent you do the augering, as in the case of board castings to pile. Then after creating some seating or a particular some hole for that particular pile so that it properly get seated in the strata, then you drive the pile. That is usually done for inclined piles. Anyway, I will explain it further. Now the commonly used methods are hammer driving. In hammer driving, you have the drop hammer, the conventional drop hammer. Just by gravity you have a guide for that hammer, and you will just drop that hammer on the pile top. Then it is a single acting hammer and double acting hammer, that is by means of steam you are applying the pressure on the pile. And the last one is the diesel hammer, which is quite commonly used. Then comes vibratory pile driving, rarely used. Then jetting technique is used, and partially augered method. So these are the various methods. Now let us see each and every method in detail. Now first one is the hammer driving. So hammer driving is a very conventional method, and it is an old method too. So here you have a hoist mechanism. You can see here a boom, which is a hoist mechanism. You have a guide here, and you have the hammer, and this is a helmet placed on top of the pile, and the hammer falls right on the this kind of cushion to protect the pile. So this is a straightforward method, that by gravity you have a certain height, and from that height you make this hammer fall down. That is a hammering method. Now let us see what is a drop hammer. So in drop hammer, you already saw that winch, and in that you just lift the hammer to a certain height and you drop the hammer on the pile top. But some things you have to take care is, You must provide a cap on top of the pile, and there must be a sufficient cushion between that cap and the pile. Also, on the pile cap, you must have a hammer cushion, and all these cushions and these caps are provided for protecting the pile from the damage due to that hammering, and also to prevent the impact of the hammering, or otherwise it will create a lot of vibrations and noise. So in order to prevent this, we provide a sufficient cap as well as cushion. But this is an old technique because of the slow rate of the hammer blows. So nowadays we don't prefer this conventional drop hammer method. Next is the hammering by means of steam or air pressure. So there are two methods. One is the single acting hammer, and another is the double acting hammer. So the difference between single acting hammer and double acting hammer is that in single acting hammer, for lifting you will use the air pressure, that is for lifting the hammer you use the air pressure, and by dropping it will drop by gravity. Whereas in the case of double acting hammer, you lift the hammer by means of steam, and the same steam pressure is applied to push the hammer downward and downward to drive the pile. So the advantage of double acting hammer is that as you are using the pressure, the air pressure or the steam pressure, to push the hammer towards the pile, the impact energy is very high. It is a diesel hammer. Diesel hammer nowadays it is commonly used. So in diesel hammer you have a ram. Ram means you have a hammering portion, and there is a fuel injection system, and at the bottom of that system you have an anvil. I will show what this will be, the anvil, and here there is a gap. This is the fuel injection system here, and here you have the ram. So now the ram is raised manually, and then fuel is injected. Now when the hammer is released, the it is dropped on the anvil definitely, and what happens, the air filled mixture get compressed and it is ignited, and thus a pressure is developed, and that pressure pushes the this anvil, that pressure helps to drive the pile. And now the lifting is done automatically, because that kind of recoil due to that pressure, when it hits the pile cap, it will come up automatically. But only for the initial lifting you have to do it by manual means. Now this method generally it is not applicable in very soft soils, because first of all the downward movement of pile is very excessive, so you cannot control the driving. Another thing is the upward movement is not sufficient enough for a second impact. That means if you want to again have an impact or to create sufficient this air fuel mixture to make sufficient pressure, it is not possible. So we cannot use this for very soft soils. Now I will show you the mechanism of diesel hammer, how this diesel hammer is working. So in this diesel hammer, just you can see the first figure shows that the piston is racing, as in the case of a engine or of any car. This is the same method what the diesel hammer is, how it is working. So first the piston is raised, and then the diesel is injected, and then it is compressed, and that compression leads to the impact and explosion. Now once the impact is taking place, then it again gets lifted up automatically. Now it draws the fresh air through the exhaust port, and again the diesel is injected, and the process continues. Next is vibratory pile driving. So here in this pile driving, you can see here there are two exciters. This is, you can call it as two weights or two exciters. These two exciters develop a sinusoidal wave, because when these two exciters rotate, they create a horizontal centrifugal force, and that centrifugal force gets cancelled, and only the vertical component is remain, and that will allow the pile to push down. So this is a dynamic force. So this movement of this exciters will create a dynamic sinusoidal wave, that is a vertical load, impact load. So that impact helps to push the pile downward. That is why this method is called a vibratory pile driving method. So here some of the key points are: the frequency of vibration is always kept equal to the natural frequency of the pile soil system for better results. Then generally used in sandy or gravelly soil for better penetration, because you know vibration method, what happens that the granular materials get displaced as the pile moves down under vibration. So apart from the insulation of pile, due to this vibration the surrounding soil also gets densified. So it is actually, that is the advantage of pile driving. When you have smaller cross-section piles and the piles are not that deep, then it is always advisable to have the pile driving rather than the board cast in situ for a very gravelly soil like sand, gravel, etc., because it will also densify, this vibration also densifies the surrounding soil. And again this method is preferred generally when the normal, the conventional hammering or diesel hammering method is a kind of explosion, so noise is very high. Also the vibrations due to that explosions are also very high. So when you have to do some controlled way of installation, then you have to go for the vibratory pile drive. Now the less conventional methods, that is the jetting technique and the partial augering method. Jetting technique is generally done if you are want to install a pile in a soft soil, drive a pile in a soft soil, and you have a thin layer of a hard strata on that soft soil. So definitely to remove that thin layer, you have to do some jetting. That thin layer must be of gravel or sand, it will be hard. So what you do is you have a nozzle at the tip of the pile which is having a jetting, through which you can jet the water. That means it will apply water pressure on the soil, and it will remove that gravelly material and sand, and it will assist the pile to move downward. So that is the jetting technique, so that this hard soil get loosened up. Next is a partial augering method, generally used for inclined piles. These are very rarely used methods anyway, And in this method, using an auger, you will first drill a hole in the soil, and then you have a seating or sufficient space for the pile to get seated in that strata. Then you apply the driving force, whichever method you have, either diesel hammer or steam hammer. Then you apply the hammering, and then for the required depth, you drive the pile. So these are the various methods of pile driving. Now, the various methods of pile driving has impact on the hammer blow as well as the hammer type of hammer used. So the efficiency of pile driving is also influencing the capacity of pile. That is why I just gave an idea about the types of pile driving. So here I will just show you an important note. See here, the hammer efficiency depends on various factors such as pile driving equipment, driving procedure, type of the pile, as well as the ground condition. So for drop hammer, the conventional drop hammer, this hammer efficiency is 0.75 to 1. And if it is a single acting hammer, it is 0.75 to 85. And for double acting hammer, it is 0.85. And for a diesel hammer, it is in the range of 0.85 to 1. So the efficiency is maximum for diesel hammer. So based on the driving technique, hammering technique, the efficiency of the this efficiency will influence the capacity of the pile. So you get the best capacity for the diesel hammer because efficiency is one, up to one. Similarly, you have the efficiency of hammer blow. So that is another efficiency. So you have two efficiencies. One is the hammer efficiency and another one is the efficiency of the hammer blow. So how will you find the capacity using the dynamic method? First of all, we'll look into it. Then we will come to this again. So Healy found out a formula, developed a formula to find the ultimate capacity of a driven pipe. And that is given by the expression here, QU equal to capital W small h eta B eta h divided by S plus C by 2, where W is the weight of the hammer, small h is the drop height, eta B is the hammer blow efficiency, and eta h is the hammer efficiency. S is the average settlement or final set of settlement. So how you will find S? If you have, if in the question, if they give that average settlement for some 6 or 7 blows is like 10 mm, then 10 mm is the S. But if they say that the penetration, total penetration of 25 mm or 25 centimeter in the last 10 blows, if they say like that, then you have to take the average value, that is 25 divided by 10. So that is the final set of penetration per blow. You are taking it as per blow. So that part you must be very careful. Another is C, that is the sum of temporary elastic compression. Elastic compression can be due to the pile, dolly, pack, dolly and packing, as well as the ground. So that is, that will be given. Yes. And now let us see the important points which you have to take care of while solving this equation, solving this problem. So already I mentioned about the hammer efficiency. Now moving on to the hammer blow. Hammer blow depends on the weight of the hammer, the weight of the pile, the anvil, helmet, etc., and the coefficient of restitution. Now this coefficient of restitution, it varies from 0 for a deteriorated condition of the pile head to 0.5 for a steam run. So this, you need not worry about the coefficient of restitution. Either you can adopt from code. When we do any field related issues, problems, we go for the codes. And for exam point of view, all these constant values will be provided. So only thing is that you must be familiar with the formula, what all terms are there. And the formula also you have to by heart, okay. So to find the hammer blow efficiency, you have to use either of these two expressions. That is, if the weight of the hammer is greater than the product of portion of restitution and the pile weight of the pile, then you have to find the efficiency using this expression. And if the weight of the hammer is less than the product of portion of restitution and the weight of the pile, then this expression is used. Now moving on to the value of C, I told you C already, it will be given, you need not find out. But just for understanding, C is actually the sum of this C1, C2 and C3. where C1 is the temporary compression of Dolly and packing. So C is overall compression due to this hammering, that is temporary compression is considered. So C1 is the initial compression due to the Dolly and packing, C2 is the temporary compression of the pile, and C3 is the compression of the ground. So you have the expressions for C1, C2 and C3 here. So you not go too much into the detail, just understand what is C1, C2 and C3. Now let us solve a problem. Now we will get more familiarized if you do one problem. So here in this question, you need to find the capacity of a driven pile using the dynamic method, that is the Healy's formula. There are a lot of other formulas, but in your syllabus, in your curriculum, you only have to study this Healy's equation. So here an RCC pile of weight 50 kN is given, and it is driven by a single acting steam hammer weighing 40 kN. The height of fall is 1 meter. Average settlement per blow is 1 centimeter. Now elastic compression is given as 1.8 centimeter. The coefficient of restitution E is 0.5, and you need to find the safe load, and the factor of safety is 2.5. So what are the things given? You have the weight of the pile P is 50 kN. You have the weight of the hammer, which is 40 kN. Then you have the height of fall is 1 meter, that is I am taking it in centimeter, 100 centimeters. Then you have the average settlement per blow. So here it is already given as average settlement per blow. So you can directly take this 1 centimeter. But in some questions, they may ask settlement in the last 6 blows is 25 centimeters. So in that case, you have to find the average value, that is 25 centimeter divided by 6. So that will be the S. Okay. That is only another way they can ask this settlement. Then comes the elastic compression. Elastic compression C is already, it is given. It is a total value, capital C, which is 1.8 centimeter. Now coefficient of restitution, small e is given as 0.5. Also the factor of safety is given 2.5. So from this you have to find the maximum, you have to find the safe load of the pile. So before going into that, you must first fix the hammer efficiency. That is the eta H is the hammer efficiency, and you have the hammer blow efficiency eta B. So in most of the questions in universities, sometimes they won't be giving this. So here they are mentioning that it is a single acting steam hammer. So for that you have eta H. But if you solve this problem by assuming eta H as 1, it is well and good. There is no issue, because if you don't know the eta H, you can use 1. Without eta H, you can solve the equation. So for a proper understanding, let us have an eta H, because as they have mentioned it as single acting steam hammer, you have the eta H in the range of 0.75 to 85. So as we are finding the capacity, it is always go for the minimum value. So I am taking the minimum value of eta H as 0.75. I am assuming the minimum efficiency. So eta H is fixed as 0.75. Now how will you find eta B, that is hammer blow efficiency? For that you must first compare the weight of the hammer and the product of the coefficient of restitution and the weight of the pile. So you have two expressions here. If the weight of the hammer is greater than this product, then you have to go for this particular equation, and if the weight is less than EP, then you have to go for this equation. So let us see here. Here weight is 40 and E into P is 0.5 into 50, that is 25. So here the weight is greater than E into P. So the hammer blow efficiency is computed using this expression, eta B is equal to W plus E square P divided by W plus P. So just substitute the values, you get the eta B as 0.583. So you have the eta H and the eta B. Now just go to the equation. The equation here, you have the ultimate capacity QU is equal to WH eta B eta H by S plus C by 2. Already we know all the terms. So substitute the value of W, which is 40. Height, I have taken it in centimeters, so it is 100. Eta B is 0.583, eta H is 0.75, S is 1 centimeter, C is 1.8 centimeter, and that is why I have taken this in centimeter, the height. Otherwise, you can take this in meters, no problem. So the final answer, the ultimate load is 920.53 kilonewton, and the safe load is divided by QU divided by factor of safety, which is 368.21 kilonewton. So this is a very simple problem, and usually this problem is asked for 8 marks. So if you know all the terminologies and the equation, this particular equation, you can easily score the 8 marks. Okay. So that's all for today's lecture. In the next session, we will be discussing about the group efficiency of piles and the pile load test. Also, another terminology called negative skin friction. This I will be discussing in the next class. Okay. Thank you.